I'm going to tell you about my tour to Bhutan in 2016 and its emphasis on happiness. Bhutan is between Tibet and India, and in tourism we emphasize on high value and low impact. Here's some basic information about Bhutan, its size and population. I chose Bhutan's Swallowtail Travels because I got very good reviews on TripAdvisor. I chose a tour named Happiness Bhutan Cultural and Festival Tour. This took 14 days and everything was included: the visa, accommodation, guide, driver and food. This is my guide. He got a bachelor degree in business administration and a license as a guide from the government. To become a guide, you had to go to an interview, take 1 month long course and a written exam. Here's my driver. He's also an auto mechanic and it was great fun to be with those guys. Many nice accommodation. The first place I went to was the Tiger's Nest. You can see the red arrow pointing at the nest. The hike takes about 5 to 6 hours with lunch and looking around the monastery. The air is quite thin because it's about 350 meters above sea level. Altitude gain is about 900 meters. And most photos I've seen from Bhutan is of Tiger's Nest, which is a very beautiful place with amazing view. The roads were quite bad, but my drive was excellent, and there's a lot of road construction, so maybe they will be better in the future. I saw some wildlife, and the muskox and prayer flags. And then I went to Ura Festival. And it was very colorful and great fun to see it. Young girls in very beautiful dresses. Here's a traditional house. I was told that some people find Bhutan similar to Switzerland, and I agree, I've been to both places. You can go rafting in Bhutan, but I didn't do it. As many monasteries and religious places. Here's a man with a prayer wheel. There are many photos of the former and the king now. Here's Trongsa. Kings were first governors there before ascending to the Raven Crown. It's the largest fortress and district headquarters and a monastery today. Here's a poster about politics, and more posters about elections. I went to a brewery where they make Weiss beer, and also a cheese factory where they make Gouda cheese. These two factories were founded by Fritz Mauer from Switzerland. They make also whiskey in Bhutan. It's a Scotch malt whiskey blended with grain, neutral spirits and spring water. Mainly produced by the Army Welfare Project to pay army pensions, provide loans, and finance scholarships. I visit a waving center. Here's Highlander's tent. And construction work. I stayed in a small village and took a walk in the morning. Transportation of monks, young monks in another place, and monks having fun. All the kings have been crowned. Transportation of beautiful girls. So many beautiful buildings, mostly religious. Here nuns, they're both nuns and monks in Bhutan. Thimphu is the capital and the largest city. The statue is made of bronze covered with gold, and inside are the 125,000 smaller Buddha statues. I took this photo outside. Here a student learns 13 traditional arts. Went to a traditional hot stone bath. They put the stones on the fire there. Then on the right side, and I went into the left side in the hot water. It was very comfortable. I like what they say in this bookstore. You can't buy happiness, but you can buy books. That's kind of the same thing. I like this legal quote that the government cannot create happiness for its people. There is no purpose for the government to exist. I visit the Gross National Happiness Center. The fourth king said the Gross National Happiness is more important than gross domestic product. It's organization of the Gross National Happiness. There are four pillars and domains, and they have service in all Bhutan to find out where they can improve happiness. You see the domain and indicators and indicator weight. And Bhutan has been emphasizing on happiness at the United Nations with this resolution. Here's a definition of happiness. Happiness refers to a deep, abiding happiness that comes from living life in full harmony with the natural world, with our communities and fellow beings, and with our cultural and spiritual heritage. In short, from feeling totally connected with our world. With an emphasis on happiness at the United Nations has also affected other countries. I got this flight magazine at the Emirates with a chapter about Bhutan's emphasis on happiness and also what they're doing in Dubai. In Dubai they have a special minister of happiness. This emphasis has also led to the World Happiness Report, which is very interesting. They asked questions. Please imagine a ladder with steps numbering from 0 at the bottom to 10 at the top. The top of the ladder represents the best possible life for you, and the bottom of the ladder represents the worst possible life for you. On which steps of the ladder would you say you are personally feel you stand at this time? And this map shows the happiness. The green countries are very happy and not the red ones. And here they break down to explain it, the happiness in different countries, the color codes like social support, healthy life experiences, freedom to make life choices and so on. The Nordic countries have normally been in the top in happiness, and in the latest report from 2020, there's a special chapter about happiness in the Nordic countries. Because I'm Icelandic, I find this very interesting. Because this is one of the main reasons why Iceland is so high on the list on happiness. Social support. If you were in trouble, do you have relatives or friends you can count on to help you whenever you need them or not? This is also very interesting concerning generosity. Studies showing that health benefits are greater for the givers than the receivers. These young men are probably planning the future of Bhutan.